Hi everybody, I'm so excited to share our brand new products that are coming out in the June catalog, just a few weeks away. And I was able to pre-order a selected group of products and I want to share with you what those are so you know what you can look forward to, just a little sampling of what you can look forward to in the upcoming catalog. If you're a demonstrator, you can order now from a selection of products. And if you want to join, if you decide you want to get a discount or join the Stampin' Up! Family, you can choose these items as part of your starter kit. So the starter kit's awesome. It's any $125 worth of products for just $99, ships free, and no further obligation. So if you have a wish list that's $100 or more, it is a no-brainer to just join and stick it out as long as you can. It's a great deal, and I would love for you to join my team and all that that encompasses, but there's a whole separate video for that. But anyways, well, you know, you can get these things now if you really, really want them. First up, new colors. I love when new colors come out. It's always an exciting time, and these speak to me like nobody's business. I always was drawn to the Regals family, the rich colors, and so these are right up my alley. I just love them, and let me tell you what they're called. So we've got a new green, and it is called Just Jade. And you can get it in 8.5 by 11. You can get it in the 12 by 12 multi-pack. There's multi-pack for 8.5 by 11 or individual colors. And there's a really cute little card kit that has jade in it. This one is Bumblebee. That's our new yellow. And then we've got a new pink, and that one's called Magenta Madness. Then we have a new blue that is called Misty Moonlight. I want to make sure I get these right. Cinnamon Cider. You know, it's funny. I was talking with my group about what colors I was hoping for, and I said a caramel. And I think I scored on that one. That's pretty close. And I love, I was always a fan of Midnight Muse, which is not quite this, and Dapper Denim, which again, it's different. But let me show you the blues. The colors are really, I think, great. These are some of my favorite in colors in a long time. I really love that combination. Now, of course, you've got these little 6x6 pattern papers, and I love those. And here they are. So here is the Cinnamon Cider. Great for, these are all great for fall. But you can add these new, this is kind of can go with your neutrals too. A little extra thing here. Bumblebee. It's not quite crushed curry. I was asking, people were asking me what I thought about the differences. And so I'm going to do a separate video showing the, you know, the bumblebee up next to a crushed curry. Maybe I'll put this next to a soft suede and some other pinks in the pink family and show you the differences between these. I kind of want to say that like the blue, for example, is a little bit of a heathered, maybe not quite, but just it's just a muted tone. It's really pretty. So, and I think it would look nicely with some of our new, like the Rococo Rose or the Terracotta Tile would look great with this. I think that would be a great combination, Terracotta Tile and Cinnamon, and then Pretty Peacock would probably look really great with this jade. So I'm gonna have to play around with those combinations and see what I can come up with. Also in the in colors, you can get the little enamel dots, and those are always great. So you've got that, and you've got this in the new colors. These ribbons look really fun. They're like, they're not hard to tie. You know, they're a nice textured weave, and they're going to make nice, beautiful bows, but not huge and bulky and weird. So these are great ribbons. And there's also, I want to show you this. This is part of the Memories and More collection. You know how there's a Memories and More collection where you can get cards and things that you can use on cards as embellishments, or you can use them in like a scrapbooking situation. But these, this little card pack is nice because you've got card bases with nice little detail on them in all the colors, but you also have these really fun envelopes. Look at that. So these are a really cute little card pack. So that's the in colors. Very exciting, very cool. The next thing I want to show you is the Celebrate Sunflowers bundle. I love this big sunflower. Let's show you how big that is, because sometimes this is not the full size. This is, it says 90%, so it's actually a little bigger. That's not a good one to show you either. Anyway, this is how big it is, and I am really looking forward to this. I'm looking forward to using this with watercolor techniques. It's very big. It's going to be a nice card front size. Size great for scrapbooking too. I love this big sunflower. So this is a great, and you've got some pretty leaves, nice sentiments. I love when you can use a stamp for birthday. You know, like, let's celebrate you would be good for birthday. But also you've got congratulations and thanks. So it's very versatile. I like that. I don't like to have to dig through my stamps for another sentiment. I like when it's all combined. But look at these dies. So you've got this outline die that'll cut out the sunflower, or you can do this with this little detail sunflower that you can add as an embellishment. Really beautiful. I like these little accents. And it's just a really great, you can do sunflower center. Really, really nice. This has a lot of detail in it. Little dots that are going to emboss. Some of them are going to cut out. Really fun dies. So this is a new bundle. When you buy the two together, you save by bundling. So always make sure to look for a bundle item number. Okay, the next one that I know is going to be popular is this jar of flowers. And it's a bundle too, with a punch, a mason jar punch. So maybe you remember the mason jar dies, and I loved that. I still have it, and I thought it was a really awesome stamp set. I really enjoyed the mason jars. So this is a fun mason jar, a new version on the mason jar with different flowers you can put. It's a little different type of imagery this time. It's really pretty. You've got stems for inside your jar and then various flowers, but here is even more fun. You've got these little shaker domes. Look at that. So you can, you know, it's sized perfectly so that you can use the little shakers, and you can fill this with, you know, little sequins and little things like that. I'm sure someone's going to come up with some fun things for that, and put those in your jar. You can maybe even put some floating, I was thinking lightning bugs in a jar somehow, maybe some little bees, not bees, what am I trying to say? Little butterflies. There's a little butterfly in here in the jar, or sequins in the jar. What else can I put in the jar? So think of things that you can put in there, maybe even a goldfish, I don't know. So I think that'll be really cute, and I love the little punch, little mason jar punch. How awesome is that? So this is going to be a really popular one, and that's a bundle also, and then you'd grab these little domes. They did come out with some little sequins in like shades of green, kind of sequins that you can put in that jar, kind of made to go with the florally theme. Those will look pretty in there. I want to show you this gorgeous ribbon pack that also kind of goes along with these, the flower theme. It's kind of flowers for every season. And there was a designer series paper, and unfortunately I didn't grab the designer series paper. I would have, it's just that it wasn't available. Had I waited one more day, because now it is available. But I really wanted my stuff, you understand, right? So this is a pack, and I really like that they're doing these packs, because rather than buy, you know, a huge, I think sometimes they're 10, 12 yards. I think these are a little bit smaller, so you get maybe 8 yards, 6 yards, I'll have to look it up, less, but then you get three different colors. And yet the combination, all these three, is $10. This is US. And before, you would buy maybe this by itself would be $8, and this by itself would be $8 or $7, and this might be $7. And so altogether, it was more expensive for you. But now you can get this like combination of ribbons that go great together or individually, and you can save a little bit of money because they've bundled them and a little less yardage. So I actually was able to buy two of these, and I did, because I love this one. This one by itself sold me, but this is beautiful too. It's got the blue, the brand new, I already forgot the blue's name. I want to call it Midnight Muse, but it's not Moonlight. What is it? Let me check. Moonlight something. Anyway, I'll look it up. And this gingham, I love that little gingham. And the white is always good for everything. And you could probably, you know, dye the white in different colors. So I love this ribbon combination. Now I really like this one, and I'll explain why. I love this greenery. I like that it's kind of those distinctive stamps where you've got these really intricate tones in the same stamp. You can get the deep and light color variations all in one stamp without having to do like a two-step stamp. And so it's a really pretty stamped image. It makes a nice image. I love the little splatter and nice sentiments. But what I also liked about it are the dies, because, you know, it's nice to add greenery behind something. You know, maybe you just want to have a little greenery behind a tag or a label or a sentiment. So I think that these dies, with or without the stamps, are really great because they're sizes in small little bits of greenery, bigger pieces of greenery, and then also cutouts for these images that are just perfect. And you know, often I want to use a little bit of a little sprig, a little something behind a tag or a sentiment, and this is perfect for that. You can do them in vellum or you know, a green color, or even a gold or silver sprig of flowers or greenery. So this is a really pretty die, and I think this is really useful, and I think these images are really beautiful, so I like that. And then even more, well, not even more, I think this is my favorite, but beautiful, is the paper. Green is a nice addition to all kinds of things, you know, all your flower images, your plant images, so you can get a lot of use out of green. And so this is a really pretty one, and I want to show you how pretty. I like that Stampin' Up! Has used all the different greens from our color family, so if you want to pair it with a shaded spruce or an old olive, you still can. Look at this. Love that. And then so you've got, you know, you've got pear, you've got mint, you've got everything, so you can use any green. This is a beautiful fern watercolor. Love that. Nice background. So sometimes we need little tiny backgrounds. So I think this is a really pretty paper pack, and I think if you look at it closely, you will really see the usefulness of this. And I, of course, like the watercolor images. That's really cute. I like that. Really nice paper. This is a great background too. So I think this is called Forever Fern is the name of this collection, and I think it has great paper, great stamps, awesome dies. They also have these little gold hoops. I want to show you these. I was at first like, what, gold hoops? I haven't even opened them. And I thought, what would I use these for? You know, maybe that would be too thick or bulky, but they're actually quite thin. Let me pull one out. They're actually thin, and you know how sometimes you kind of use loose threads or linen thread or metallic thread behind a little image or a sentiment stamp, and that's something that we do often. I think this is kind of the same idea, but less loosey-goosey, more clean and modern, and I think that'll be a really interesting focal piece. And also maybe some techniques like the spotlight technique might be fun with these gold hoops. So I was at first thinking to myself, why would I want gold hoops? Let me think about it. And now I'm kind of excited to try this in some techniques. So I was actually excited to get these. And if we get to start doing classes again soon, I think we are going to, I grabbed a couple of them because I wanted to make sure to have enough for classes. I'm being optimistic. So in-person classes, love those. I miss all my stampers. Another part of this collection is another ribbon combo pack, another awesome thing. And it's a really nice, this is, it's hard to see on video, I bet, but it's like a really fun texture. It's not cheesecloth, but, I mean, it's like, it's almost muslin, but not quite. It feels really nice. It's going to lay flat. It's interesting. And then you've got some, it's like a gold, it's like linen thread, but gold is what that is. So this is a really fun collection. This is the Forever Fern Suite. Oh, there's one more piece to this. Forgot. Is this it? Yes. So this, ooh, look at that. I hadn't seen it in person. This is the first time I've seen it. Look at this. This is gold laser cut paper. And these are awesome. I wish you could see these in person. This one kind of wants to come out. He says, take me out. Look at this. You're going to punch a circle in something and stamp a sentiment on here, and you've already got that greenery I was talking about. It's already kind of springing out from behind. You can have a white layer, but look at that beautiful gold. That is fun. And here are, look at this fern. That is beautiful. This giant fern. Some wreaths. This is gorgeous. Let's see what else is in here. There's a few layers that are just the same as this one. Let's see, one, two, three so far. Okay, three layers like that. And then look at this. So we've had laser cut paper before, but I think this is the first time it's been in gold, and it's pre-punched out. You don't have to, remember before we had to be really careful cutting. And so here, these have already been cut. They're just barely hanging on to each other. So you've got, these are sized great for a card front. Of course, you can snip them up if you wanted to. Look at that. This is beautiful. Okay, this is called the Forever Greenery, or I'm sorry, Forever Gold Laser Cut Specialty Paper. That's pretty awesome. I was excited to see that in person, and I'm glad I did. Okay, there's that collection. Okay, here I want to show you this collection. These two together can come as a bundle. It's called Beautiful World, and the dies on here are really fun. You've got a globe and a globe stand. You could pick which side of the globe you want to show. I like that. That's nice. They didn't just stick with just, you know, North America, like, you know, like focusing on the side of the globe that we live in, because, you know, Stampin' Up! Is very global. We've got demonstrators all over the place, so it's nice that we have these options. I really like this feather and these scripty words. This is kind of like, you know, it's embossing. It's not going to cut out, so it's going to add texture in just a little area, and that could be really interesting, maybe with some sponging just to highlight them. That's kind of fun. And this little accent piece. So this can be a really beautiful set, but I think also the globe can be used for school days, maybe a teacher card too, if you, instead of using some of the more beautiful elements, stick with some more primary and black maybe, and that could be really fun for a school days type of thing too. So really nice font here. And nice for thank you, but also congratulations for maybe a graduation. You make the world a better place. You know, there's a lot of people doing that right now, making the world a better place, and this is great for that. This would be fun for a card like that. Ideas are already forming for this. So, and then there's also a Memories and More collection pack. This is a collection of cards that you can use on a card front. You know, maybe you want to make this into a greeting card. Or if you use these little cards for journaling or accents on a scrapbook page. So these are fun, and there's always a nice collection here of those. Nice imagery to go with. Look at that, that's really pretty. These are kind of masculine, which is nice. Sometimes we don't have that. Here's a nice little gold pieces. Look at these. These are really beautiful. And here's some sticker sheets. So really pretty card pack. And there's more to this collection. I'm really excited to show you a couple more things. This is an embossing folder called Old World Embossing, it's Old World Paper. So it's like crumpled paper. It's like doing the crumpling and then smoothing out for you, which is kind of funny. But, you know, we like to have our controlled messes, don't we? So this is our crumpled paper look all there for us. This is a fun little embellishment. Little corners, like photo corners. Let's see if I can open that. Little photo corners, you know, you can put on the top of a photo. And then here, little ribbon slides or buckles. So those are fun. Kind of an antique brass. And then let me find the ribbon for this. I want to touch this one. It's early espresso faux. Where is the end? There it is. Okay, so it's like, has a suede texture. No, it does. A suede leathery texture to it. That's fun. And it's, again, it's you would think that would make it not tieable, but I think it is. Or it'd be nice in a knot, maybe. I think you could do a little bow, but it might look nice as a knot or just some trim. So that's really pretty. But here I want to show you the paper. Find it. Okay, here we have some beautiful trim, some foiling on here. So you've got these foil elements. This is called brass. They're calling it brass, not gold. And there's even brass foil sheets, which I did not get in my haste. So you've got these really pretty brass detail. Oh, this is pretty. Look at this one. Look at that one. That's fun, like a top view of a globe. And this is a great background. These are really pretty. Obviously, you see a lot of that new, I'm going to call it caramel, but it's actually, what is it again? Cinnamon. Cinnamon paper and a bumblebee. Really great. Oh, here's another fun one. Look at this one. Really fun papers in this collection. So this is a great paper collection. A lot of masculine imagery here. And that's fun too. So that's a great new collection. Okay, here is another great die collection I want to show you. This is called Tasteful Touches, and there's a few things I like about this. First off, the dies. I think lately the dies really make it for me. These are great dies. It's going to cut out a label with a little detail to it, so even though it's cutting out this label, it's kind of going to give you a bumped edge, like its own little trim around it, so that's beautiful. It's like pre-framed. It's framing itself. Really nice little cutout there, and I think that's really pretty. And this is a nice one too. It adds little dots on the sides of the cutout. So this is a really beautiful label set, and it's got sizes big and small, so this is going to fit all your sentiments. And Tasteful Touches stamp set has this really cute feather. I like that, really pretty, and some pretty touches that you can use in your backgrounds on all your cards. And then this is, I like this. I think I'm going to watercolor this. I love that. And I like this just saying hello for now. That is something we want to say right now to people who we're sending cards to, right? Just saying hello to people who are away from us, or you are so special. Some people who are helping us out, good things in life are better with you, can't wait to see you type thing. So this is really fun and beautiful, I think. Fun in the labels and that what you can do with that, but then also just really lovely. And another part about this is a die, or not a die, I'm sorry, an embossing. It says Tasteful Textile, 3D embossing, and it looks like it's kind of turning it into a linen-y looking weave, I guess is what I'm trying to say. It's hard to show you that, so, but that's what that does. And then there are some wooden elements somewhere on my desk from this one. I can find them. Yep, little wooden cutouts. Those are fun. And the paper pack for this one. Now this is one of those paper packs where you get more, like usually you get, you know, 12. But this is one of those paper packs that comes with 24 sheets. Let me see if I can open it. So it's a little more expensive, but you're gonna use these like crazy on everything. Okay, look, you got a wood plank. We all know we love that one. That was a popular paper from before. So you've got, and then on the back, it's like tile, like on my neighbor's bathroom floor, actually. A little, you know, it's like a beehive of tile here. Really kind of interesting. Here's that texture, like the embossing folder does. It's like a fabric, like a burlap almost fabric. And then here we've got some kind of subway tile or tile here. And now we got darker planks and some maybe gesso paint mix here. Kind of fun. Here's another shade of planks. And on the back, look at that one. That one's pretty. And that's that blue again, that new blue. Here's a pretty background. Nice gray kind of slate looking background. And here we've got another different textured tile. These tiles, they're just really fun. These are going to make really, and here's more wood. These are going to make, looks like a rug. Great backgrounds. These are going to be backgrounds you are going to use like crazy. This is fun. Looks like a towel almost, a blanket. You want to snuggle up on that one. And here's a different tile pattern. Like someone went to a tile showroom and took photos. Here's some more plaster, maybe. Here's a nice tile. Another plaster smear. Oh, and another tile pattern. If you're retiling your bathroom, you know, bring this paper to your tiler and say, do that. Here's another fabric. That's nice. Another fabric. Another tile. Really fun. And here's a really light wood. You're gonna use this paper in your backgrounds like crazy. I know I am. So I actually bought two packs of this because, I mean, I use the wood side, but then how do you choose? Because you've got this awesome stones and fabric-y side. It's hard to choose, so then I had to get two packs. So that suite is called Tasteful Touches, or In Good Taste Suite. And that's a lot of fun stuff in there. Okay, now that's it for the suites that I have right now, but I have a lot of stamps. Okay, this one I really liked a lot. It's called Lovely You, and I liked it because of the fonts. Always just because you're my person, so cute, wildly grateful. Love is what makes us family. Miles apart, but still in my heart. Cherished friend, trust me, your lovely smile, let's cheer you up. So these are kind of fun sentiments that we don't have in all of our stamp sets. So like the family one, let's cheer you up. Just because all these are great. But the awesome thing too is this can be bundled with this new little punch. Okay, and this punch, it's called I forget what they call this, triple banner. Let's see. Lovely, you pick a punch. Pick a punch. Okay, so let's show you what this does. Okay, so depending upon what size, like this is an inch piece of paper. I'm gonna stick it in here. Oops. And it's gonna, oh, I didn't do that straight at all. Let's do the other side. There, so you have this whole inch. So if you want a sentiment that's an inch wide, you can use that. But it has different wells, so you've got a 1 inch wide space, and then you've got an inch and a half, and then I have to measure that. Not an inch and a half, 3/4 of an inch, and then a half an inch. So you can make your tags different widths, so that's fun. So you can kind of decide how wide. So then if you're two different styles, two different designs on the top, this one's kind of more elegant, this one's more straightforward. So you can kind of make many different sizes of, you know, little labels for your sentiments, and then you can stamp, you know, whatever you want. The love was what makes us family, and obviously maybe not on the gingham, and it's also nice for layering. So let's say you want a border, you can do a 1 inch piece and then get another size. What size is this? I'm not sure, but you can go in again. Oh, here, that fits in there, and it'll punch out, you know, another. It's too short. I should have prepared. Sorry. Let me grab something. So now I've got it, and it's like lined up. So I did the shorter. This is a skinnier one. This is 3/4, and then there's an even smaller one. So that must be a half an inch. So you've got this nice little. And you can do both sides and layer them and have nice little layered sentiments. So that's a fun bundle. Another bundle is Field of Flowers. I liked this one for another reason too. I like that these little puffy flowers, and they go on here. I like the little words, always in my heart, always my friend. You are always in my heart, you know, thinking of you always. So you can kind of blend these together, which I like. I think those are kind of fun. Little background, little line of leaves there. But this I thought was really fun because there are so many times when I want to add, now this is a border punch, so you can kind of make these flowers all along the border, but I think I'm going to mostly use these. I want to punch out all these flowers at once. I want to put little tiny rhinestones in them. I want to use them for an animal crown. I want to put a crown of flowers on top of some animal with these tiny little flowers. That's my go and find one of my dies that has itty bitty flowers and then cut out a bunch of little tiny flowers to put a crown on my, I did a unicorn not too long ago from the Leave a Sparkle stamp set. So anyway, little tiny flowers. Love the little tiny flowers. So I like this a lot. And that is why I bought this, for the tiny flowers. But I do think this is a nice stamp set. So this is another a bundle. Okay, another bundle is the Many Mates. I think out of this one, I like the stamp set better than the die. I like the die, it's fun, and I bought it, but I think that it kind of can go with anything. It's not necessarily, you don't need, so you can get just the die even and use that as a background. It's quite lovely. Or you can get just the stamp set, or if you know you're going to use both, might as well get them together and bundle it. But the Many Mates is nice because it has a lot of sentiments in it. I always look for stuff like that. I like that it has an anniversary and a birthday. This congrats is cute for graduation. And just all kinds of sentiments that you can mix and match. So I think this is a really awesome stamp set. This is a fun die. I don't know that they have to go together. So, and then of course you can cut these to different sizes, you know. So that's these two. Another one is called Blossoms in Bloom. And I liked it because I like this. I was drawn to this. And you probably can guess why. I love to watercolor, and this looks like watercolor. So I was instantly drawn to this stamp, and I really like the sentiments. Again, I don't like to have to dig for sentiments. So this has a birthday, a thinking of you, hello, thank you, get well. So I love that it has everything I need in one stamp set. I like that the centers of the flowers are separate, so I can do a different color. And so I really like this. This is a really great stamp set. And so I think it can be used without the dies. However, the dies are really fun. So I did grab them. And what you've got with the dies is you've got, and I'm going to open it because there's more than just this one. It's actually bigger than you think. Ah, there it is. Okay, so you're layering. You're going to layer on top of each other. So this one can be layered. So you're adding detail, basically. If you, you know, you can add a little tiny bit of detail on top of this. And underneath it all, you can have this. You can stamp this and then layer. So you can do different things. I'm gonna have to play around with this and see how these layers work together. But you've got the really skinny line. And then you can use the little skinny line die on its own, just a little accent of flowers on your, or even this one could probably be used on its own too, and then you can layer the two together to get, you know, like a really detailed flower with a darker color and a lighter color and make some really beautiful combinations. So that's this one, and it's called Blossoms in Bloom, and I really think that's going to be fun. Okay, I bought this one. I was very excited about this one. So this one I was put right into my cart right away. I like birds. I love birds, actually. And I have a little bird feeder. I love that we have cardinals that come almost every morning, and if there's no food outside, they kind of chirp. They're like, hey, don't forget. Anyway, so it's a cute little bird set, and it's watercolory looking, don't you think? And so you, and you can kind of build layers and get deeper colors, different types of birds, little eggs. So this is kind of a scene builder, like a distinctive look stamp set. So I like that. I like, think this is going to be pretty. Putting leaves on your branch. So this is kind of a builder. You have to kind of layer and build upon your layers, but I think it is really pretty. So I like this one a lot. And the dies here again are so fun. Look at this one. This is going to be like an opening. So it just makes an opening. It doesn't cut out the circle. So then behind it, you know, this is going to be your top layer. And then you make that in a color. And then underneath it, you've got a white piece with maybe a bird in it. You know, and then that bird's going to be like framed inside this really pretty circle. And I think that's fun. I love these little branches, a little border. So the dies on here are great. And the birds are great. So I think this is a really fun collection. I don't think this one had a bundle, did it? Let me double check my box here. I don't think it had a bundle. If it did, I forgot the bundle. I don't think it did. It's called A Grand Kid. Now, I'm not a grandma. my children are still in school. But look at these stamps. Okay, this one says Best Grandkid Ever. And I don't have a grandkid, but a lot of my stampers do. And at Card Buffet and stuff, I can make a card that has a grandkid or grandpa, grandma, or, you know, grandchild, granddaughter, grandson, that kind of thing. But even that, look at this one. I like this one. No amount of money could ever show how much I love you, but here's some anyway. That's perfect for my nephews. You know, they don't really like sappy cards or pretty cards, but they'll think this is funny. They just want money anyway. Or my niece. So smart, so fun, so sweet, and so wonderful. So that could be for my niece, Sydney. So there's, an, you know, happy birthday, so proud of you. These are good for all kid cards, and I think especially teens. This is great for my nephews and nieces. So even though I'm not going to use this Best Grandkid Ever, I'm going to use all the other ones. And I think this is a really great stamp set, and it's a good price. And so I grabbed this anyway. So I first passed it because it was for grandchildren. And then I instantly started reading it. And I thought, I need this one about the money. So I always give my nephews money. So this is really fun. A Grandkid. Make sure you check it out. Don't dismiss it because of the grandparent thing. If you're not a grandparent, or if you are a grandparent, look at this, a stamp set just for you. How long has that ever happened? Hardly ever, right? So it's perfect. And sitting on my desk, I am now seeing something I forgot to show. This went with that fern set I showed you earlier, all those greeneries, and it's these little, like mini embossing folder. So I just want to show you, there's two of them, and it adds some greenery on top and bottom. And this adds a cute texture. So this is a fun, they're like little mini embossing folders. And I remembered I bought them and then I couldn't find them. I thought maybe I forgot them, but no, I did get them. Here they are. And they're part of that greenery bundle, that Forever Fern. Let me see. I wish I could show you the catalog. We can't show it to you quite yet. But yeah, these, it's a combo for $8. It's really nice. So you get these two, add two different textures. And it's called Greenery Embossing Folders. And something else I forgot to show you is a bumblebee gingham ribbon. And I think this was part of that Map and World collection. And I forgot to show you that too. I have a whole box full of things I was digging through and I missed a few things. So it's gingham, it's that bumblebee gingham. So super cute. I think you're gonna love the new items in this catalog. And like I said, if you join now, you can start ordering now. If you have shopped with me in the last 6 months, a catalog is coming to you. I have sent them out already automatically straight from Stampin' Up. So they think they said they were gonna go out this week. So they should be on your way. They go bulk mail, so they are a little slow right now, especially because I think the post offices are a little overwhelmed right now. So, keep looking for that in your mailbox in the coming weeks. And if you have any questions about it, please feel free to give me a call. Head over to my Facebook page. I'm trying to keep people stamping together by having challenges and other fun things. And that's Beth's Paper Cuts. And my group, where we have like more chit-chatty back and forth, is Beth's Paper Cuts Idea Sharing Group. And that is where you can post cards to. What are you making? Show me what you're making. And you can be a demonstrator or a customer. It doesn't matter to me. We're just stamping together and having fun. So head over there and join me at my Facebook group. I would love if you did. And again, if you want to join my team, feel free to do that. I would love to have more team members, and you can stamp with me on. We have a whole nother separate group just for that. So anyway, thanks for watching. I hope you get excited about these new products coming your way. And if you have any questions, feel free to ask. Thanks for watching. Bye.